Oh, good morning, church. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. We're so glad, just like last week, that we have a place to call home in our church family that celebrates Christ no matter what the holiday is, that we can all be here. Well, we're going to do like we did last week. We're going to start with a few songs from the band up here, and we chose some songs that we hope everybody in the congregation, traditional, contemporary, everybody will be able to enjoy. If you're able, please stand and join us, and the words will be up on the screen. I totally started the wrong song, everybody. No, I was going to make a joke. Did anybody see the Mariah Carey thing last night? Mariah Carey totally messed up last night, and I was going to make a joke about how we're not going to be as bad as she is, but I don't know. Maybe we will be. We'll see. 1, 2, 3, 4. I did it again. No, I'm trying to start the third song. But this time, all right, it's Joy to the World, the Lord has come. Is everybody familiar with that song? Yeah, am I? All right, I got to decide. 1, 2, 3, 4. I did it. Here we go.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive her King. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
before you're seated, why don't you say Happy New Year to six people?
I'd like to invite all my friends to come forward, my young friends, kids, come on down. And as you're all coming down, I'm going to mention a couple of announcements. Come on down, you guys. It's good for you to come down. As I came today, I didn't see the giving envelopes out here. Several ask about them. I'm guessing we'll see them next week. A lot of things that have been on Wendy's agenda, so she'll get them out there for us next week. If you're not receiving any mailings from the church presently, let me know so that we'll make sure we get your address and we'll get you some envelopes made as well. Today is kind of a different day. We're meeting at 10 o'clock rather than 9 and then again at 11. Oh, come on, Jeremiah, don't miss out. And so, boy, did we miss you the last couple weeks while you were traveling. You bring excitement to this room. With this being a special day, again, as we did last time, remember we made these wonderful buckets of love, and I took them after you guys helped make them. Everybody kind of pitched in at the end of last week's service. We took them to Family Promise. I couldn't even fit them all in my vehicle. I've got a few more yet to take over. They're in the closet over here, but I had a whole vehicle full. They were overwhelmed. It was really wonderful to see the response. And, of course, as families now are discharged out into their own apartment, they'll get one of those buckets of love with all the cleaning products. Today we're going to do something really similar as we end the service, not really end it. We're doing something called Sunday Serve. These are introductions to something we're going to experiment with over the year ahead. So this Sunday Serve project for us for today will be these Good Samaritan car kits we're going to pull together. You've probably been like me. You've pulled up to a corner. You've seen somebody that's in need standing there holding a sign. These car kits have some items in them that we can hand to them, and it gives them a breakfast bar, some water, some literature talking about some of the places they might turn for assistance and some help. Some people that have grabbed these in the past, this is not new to our church. We've had these before. We've just never built them as a total church before. Some people put a McDonald's card in there so they can get a sandwich or one from Subway, or maybe they add some other little goodie in the bag as well so that when they give it to somebody at a corner like that, it's got their own touch as well. When we get done in this room, we'll dismiss to the other room, and we can all work together to get some of this put together. And you guys will look forward to maybe making some cards that can be included. We got some paper stock and things for that, so we'll work on that. Those are just a couple of things to hold up today. Let me join with these guys now and see what we got going. Oh, we got Stanley, don't we? Uh-huh. All right, make room for Phil. Let me squeeze in here someplace. All right, let's see what Stanley's got today. Oh, Stanley's heavy. All right. Stanley is not moving. I don't feel anything alive inside, right? It's not alive. Okay, that's good. I think that's good. You got that one, didn't you? Oh, look what we got.
Stuffed animals.
Stuffed animals. Anybody else got a stuffed animal?
I do.
You got a stuffed animal?
I have a lot.
You got millions? Now tell me, these are special ones to you?
Yes, I always keep a lot of them on my bed or
in the bookshelf or on your bed. Is there a favorite in here, or are these all your favorite? This one, what's this one called?
Ears.
Ears? This is a bunny. Yes, and I like this one too.
Okay.
He's a lizard. Is this a gecko or no?
I can't really tell.
We can't tell, all right. And let's see, what else do we have? What about this one?
A crab.
A crab. Sometimes when I don't get enough sleep, I'm a crab.
That's right. That's a lobster.
That's a lobster. I'm never a lobster, except for when I take a hot bath.
A bird.
And there's a bird. Oh, another bird. What is this?
That's a turtle.
A turtle. You know, right now, as we come into the new year, I'm thinking about...
This one right there.
I did? Which one?
That one.
This one?
Yeah.
Up.
What is this?
I think it comes out of a hole in kind of like a prairie. Oh, it's a prairie dog. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. And then he goes back in. So as I look at all these, I'm thinking of how beautiful and wonderful our world really is, how diverse it is, how many different flavors, in a sense, different colors, different sights, all these animals with beautiful feathers and fur and sounds, and all the things that make our planet, our world, so beautiful. And as we enter into a new year, we might think about ways in which we can kind of make our world a better place. How we can not only make it good for animals, but good for people. You know, this is, what's the date today? Does anybody know what date it is? It's what, Monday? No, today's not Monday.
Oh, yeah,
it's Sunday. Look, see, there's people out there. That means it's Sunday. Oh, Sunday and Monday. Yeah, I get that. So it's Sunday, the first day of the year. We have a whole year in which to maybe do something a little better than we did last year. So as we kind of think about how beautiful... Oh, I didn't see this one either. That's a dog. So as we go into the next year, we can make this world better or we can make it worse. Let's make it better, okay?
Okay.
Hey, let's have a prayer together before I send you back. Lord, I thank you for these kids. I thank you for all the ways in which they bless our lives and make our world a better place because they're here in it. We ask that you would inspire us through them. In your name we pray. Amen. Thanks for coming up. Heavy, heavy, heavy. Three kings are It's a time for us to pray together. This is really wonderful. As I look out, I really didn't know what to expect in terms of how many of us would make it today, but this is really more than a lot of people thought, maybe. So it's good to have you here. It's good to gather together and start this year in a time of worship. And right now, we're going to do it in a time of prayer. So I just want to know some of the prayers that maybe you've brought with you today. What are the prayers we'd hold up? Yes, Judy. Okay, let's remember Kay, who's had pneumonia, and is really, it's not a minor thing either. It was a very major kind of thing in her life, so let's keep her in our prayers. Who else do we hold up today? Others we pray for? Yes. Let's continue to keep Dick in our prayers, surgery and infection and more surgery. So let's hold him in our prayers. Yes. That's right. Let's keep Mark in our prayers after his surgery this week. Who else do we hold up? Yes. All those folks in the military. And I know that you hold them up, particularly when they're so far away from home and unable to be back in stateside or near their families. Let's keep them in our prayers. Yes. That's right. Ongoing prayers for Vicki with her new diagnosis with MS. So let's keep her in our thoughts right now. So she's in our prayers. Who else are we holding up? Others that we're remembering today. Yes. Hey, Warren's family, and in his passing, that all his friends and others will be remembering him in these days. Anybody else? George and Sandy are back from their big travels, and good to see you here. And you're a reminder of all the others that have been traveling in and out. Some aren't back yet, but we're glad to see you safe and that you had a great time out west. Others, yes. Oh, goodness. Let's keep her in our prayers after a fall and an injured neck. Thanks, Nick. Who else do we hold up? Others that we're remembering? Yes. Oh, Peter got married. Yep. Congratulations. That's right. Well, that's good. I can tell you're very, very happy. Others that we are remembering today. Anybody else that we hold up? All these celebrations around the world and the things that happened in Istanbul. Am I right? I'm just hearing the news, so I'm not sure. I'm sure we'll hear more as the hours pass, but a lot of people were killed, maybe as many as 40 or 50. Lots of people injured. And so let's keep those families in our prayers, but also our thankfulness that there were so many celebrations that weren't disrupted and that all the revelry has been safe. Any other people or situations we're remembering? Let's come together then in a time of prayer. Precious Lord, we begin our new year, and there are so many ways in which we look back and we give thanks, but Lord, help us to look forward and to recognize ways in which we can make a difference in our lives and in the world. Help us not to sit back and wait for someone else to make this world a better place, but help us to be the ones that step up in some fashion. Open our hearts, Open our minds, our eyes. Give us the strength. Cast out before us that vision that you would have for us individually and as a church. That we'll be everything that you've created us to be. Hear our prayers in this place, Lord, for those who are suffering and those who are experiencing joy. Help us to know that there's nothing in heaven or on earth that can separate us from your great love in Jesus Christ. These prayers we hold up in your holy name. Amen.
Today's scripture comes from Philippians chapter 3, verses 7 through 14. Yet whatever gains I had, these I have come to regard as loss because of Christ. More than that, I regard everything as loss because of the surpassing value of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. For his sake, I have suffered the loss of all things, and I regard them as rubbish, in order that I may gain Christ and be found in him. Not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but one that comes through faith in Christ, the righteousness from God based on faith. I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection and the sharing of his sufferings by becoming like him in his death, if somehow I may attain the resurrection from the dead. Not that I have already obtained this or have already reached the goal, but I press on to make it my own, because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead. I press on toward the goal for the prize of the heavenly call of God in Christ Jesus. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Things start out kind of slow in the first part of the year, I understand. But eventually we'll get to them, February or March or something like that.
No. Wow, where did you get this?
That's not that. Wow.
Which one of you guys did this?
This was my journal in high school. Seriously, have y'all been reading this?
This is my childhood diary.
These are my New Year's resolutions from last year.
It's my my resolution list from 1992.
I was a weird kid.
Figure out what global warming is and do something about it.
Break the world record in juggling.
Start flossing.
Keep an eye on my thinning hair.
Wow. First thing on the list, survive Y2K.
Invite Gary to church. Nope, didn't happen. It's a little hard to invite a guy you had to fire.
Stock up on water and tons of Twinkies. Boy, the struggle was real.
Teach Susie to sit, stay, and roll over. Susie's my little sister.
Get a George Clooney Caesar haircut to impress the ladies.
Binge watch Lost. Did it. Found out who was in the hatch. Bit of a letdown.
Love my mom more. Be kind to her and stop rolling my eyes. She was the first helicopter mom, probably, in the 80s.
Move out of my parents' house. I'm gonna move it to this year's list.
Work out. get less pudgy. That's a big fat no. Pun intended.
Hey, Mom.
Hi, Mom. Oh, my God.
I got you on speakerphone, so.
Oh, my gosh.
Hey.
You know, Martha, your cousin, she is going to come here to Oklahoma for college.
I'm
so glad.
Be as awesome a mommy as my mommy was to me. If only I would know how difficult that would be. She pretty much raised us by herself, so I don't think I can be near as good as she was.
Keep promise to Grandma to watch Matlock each week, then call her to discuss it. She loved that show. I didn't see one episode. I missed every episode. I miss her.
Invite Steve to church. He went with me. That night he said he wanted nothing to do with God. 3 years later, I get this call. It's like midnight, 1 a.m. He calls me and says, Ed, you're never going to believe this, but I accepted Christ. It's pretty cool.
Tell Dahlia how much I really love her.
Be a better dad. Quit yelling. I'm still working on that one.
Read the Bible more. I read the Bible more.
Start taking my faith seriously. I have done this. It's scary, but I'm doing this one.
Get to know God better. I know one thing. He loves me. Jesus loves me. I'm living proof.
Surrender my life to God fully.
Spend more time with God. That's been on my resolution list for as long as I can remember. I've been a believer for 40 years, and I always want to spend more time with Him. It's one of the most important things, and it's always one of the hardest things to just get done, you know?
Oh, I love Jesus more. Te amo, Jesus.
Your list. Over the years, can you think of some of those things that may have been resolutions that you've made, that you've thought about keeping, tried to keep, didn't keep, did keep? Here we are, the first day of 2017. I've been wondering how we'll do this year. Will we make a resolution at all, or make a few of them? Will we have some good intentions or not? Will we be busy, or will we make any better use of our time this coming year? In 365 days, when this year is over, will we be looking back with joy or with regret? Will we be looking ahead with anticipation or with dread? The Marist College Institute for Public Opinion recently conducted a poll to see what tops the New Year's resolutions for 2017. And here's the list, just the top of the list. Starting with number 6, eat healthier. Improve health is the 5th. Spend less, save more is the 4th. Exercise more is the 3rd. The 2nd is lose weight. First, polling Americans for this coming year is to be a better person. Last year, losing weight was the top of the list. And in fact, losing weight has been consistently the top of the list year after year as you go back in time. I'm not so sure that it's necessarily that we've been eating so well and losing so much weight that we've finally been able to push it down the list. In fact, I think maybe we're still on a kind of a negative pattern when it comes to weight and all those health issues. I read a funny story recently about a woman who walked into her bathroom at home, and she saw her husband weighing himself, and as he did, he pulled in his stomach. The woman thought to herself, he thinks that he's weighing less by pulling in his stomach. So rather sarcastically, she said to her husband, "That's not going to help." To which he responded, "Well, sure it will. It's the only way I can see the numbers on the scale." Weighing less. Number two, being a better person. Number one. Perhaps our desires are somewhat shaped by the noise around us. I've been wondering about this particular poll. We look and we see, and our world seems so far out of kilter. So mean-spirited in many ways. Anti-bullying may be frequently mentioned, but I'm afraid it's been overlooked by many. So this place is surely in need of better persons. I have no doubt about that. And if you're like me, you believe that our world is ultimately what we make of it, right? And there's no better place to begin a positive change than right here at home, each with ourselves. I kind of like the idea that lots of people will be seeking to be better persons this year. Not that weight loss isn't great. I'm already kind of putting that towards the top of my list as well. There's a whole lot more substance to this being a better person thing, I think. So today I'd like to suggest some ways that we might shape that idea of becoming better persons, and in the process, become better together also as a church. The first is this, and this is short and it's simple that I'm going to give you in these few points. The first is this: find some dissatisfaction and address it over this next year. You know, just coasting through life will never do. It's often said, for a church to go backward, it doesn't require people to go backward. They just need to stand still. A few weeks ago, I asked if we'd found our comfort zones in our spiritual lives, places where we just wanted to sit and kind of nest, and no change needed, no growth wanted, just kind of be where we are and kind of let life kind of take care of itself. Now, I'm not talking about finding a dissatisfaction and complaining about it, but finding something and engaging ourselves in an intentional, constructive process of making something actually better. Something about ourselves, maybe, or something about the world in which we live and engage. I wonder what this world would be like if we all saw a greater level of personal responsibility in making this world better. In practical terms, this may require us to give more of ourselves, yes, in the world, in our community, in our families, and of course in our church. Finding some dissatisfaction and working to change it. That's the first thing that I want us to remember and think about as we head into the new year. The second is this: to find some devotion. Philippians 3:13 says, "But this one thing I do." To the self-righteous young rich man, Jesus said, "One thing you lack." To busy Martha, working in the kitchen, criticizing Mary, Jesus said, "One thing is needed." Apostle Paul said in today's reading, again, one thing I do. A statement of focus. A focus of devotion. Paul's faith wasn't simply a sideshow. It wasn't a compartment of his life. You know, a wheel has many spokes. And so do we in our lives. Work and school and hobbies and family and all those things in church. But I don't think that God really wants to simply be a spoke among many. God wants to be the hub of our lives, the hub of our wheel, out of which all the spokes kind of grow, from which they all connect. Our faith shouldn't be a compartment. It should be our life. Sometimes we need to hard reset ourselves and trade some commitments of our busy lives for commitment to our faith lives. We're too busy these days. I don't need to remind you of that. It's, you know, McDonald's Monday and Taco Tuesday and out to, T-ball on Thursday and Fish Friday and all these kinds of things. Yard sale Saturday. I mean, we've got all these things lined up. We got schedules. Sleeping in on Sunday. I'm trying to get the S word or the word to connect, you know. We need to learn to say no to some things in order to say yes to others. We need to be less devoted to some things or to be more devoted to others where it really counts. Discovering or rediscovering our devotion. This is the second thing for our day. And the third, simple. I told you it'd be quick, it'd be simple. Find some direction. And I'd suggest that the only real direction is forward. You know how the old saying goes, you can't go home. I've tried to experience some of that in my own life. As I grew up in this little village in southern Michigan named Concord. And over the years, sometimes I've headed back. They've asked me to come back to my home church and preach, and I've done that. And we visit. Gail loves it when we go into the Silver Spoon and they start calling me Philly everywhere, you know. And she goes, Philly, that's kind of cute. But, you know, I even look around at my home church, and yeah, there's people that I still know that are still there from the years I was growing up, but there's many that are gone, and the sanctuary is different. It's a brand new sanctuary, and different pastor, of course. You can't really go home to your village. Looking back has got some value, but not the core value of our lives. Apostle Paul reminds us, forgetting those things which are behind. Not that forgetting them altogether is what we're talking about here. It's not making them the central core priority. Using our memories to help better the future, but not living in the past. I was thinking about some churches back in my last appointment area. There were six churches, three churches. These three decided that they would abandon all three of their buildings, come together and build one new one, kind of centrally located in a place that would maybe be very visible to people and kind of a new place relating to the new population of today, because all three of their buildings were over 100 years old. Their ministries were like ours, 140 years old. We've been here. Then there were three other churches, and about the same time, well, the storm that came through here at that time damaged one of them so bad it couldn't be repaired, and there were a couple others. They all came together and built a new church. One church, that group of churches became the Heritage United Methodist Church. And I'm not saying it's all determined about where they're going, but their very name was a looking back rather than a looking forward. The other group of churches were the New Life Church. And I'm here to tell you that I do know their church went great, just grew and blossomed and became something wonderful. Their identity of new life. Something new in the future. I don't know if you realize the name January got its name from Caesar, who named the month after the Roman god Janus, the two-faced god, one face looking forward and one face looking backward. in 2017, there's no real looking back. If we're really going to make a difference in this world, the past is indeed the past. You know, putting our hand to the plow and looking back, that's something that our scriptures remind us will cause an uneven furrow. You've got to kind of get your eye on the tree on the far end of the field and head towards that. You spend too much time looking back and you'll go off in whatever direction. John R. Rice once said, no matter what you did in the past, your future is spotless. And that is one of the challenges that many of us bring to the moment in which we live. We live less complete lives because of some of the things that were broken in our past, some of the things that didn't go all that well, and so we bring that sense of identity into the present. And of course, then that affects where we're headed into the future. Our future is spotless. And if we can live into that future with that in mind, it's an open possibility that God can work wonderful things in our lives and in the life of this church. I think that's why Apostle Paul was telling us that he didn't look back to look forward, because there were things in his own past that if he focused only on those, he couldn't have been the person he was and used in the ways that God used him. We only fail when we stop trying, and sometimes the past is the thing that keeps us from trying because we failed and we failed and we failed. I suspect some of you know that Babe Ruth, the home run hitter, he held the record for home runs for many years, but he also held another record, strikeouts. Think of that. Home runs and strikeouts. You don't get home runs unless you run the risk of striking out. Winston Churchill said, success is the ability to move from one failure on to the next, because eventually it won't be failure. Success is getting up just one more time than you fall down. No looking back at past bitterness, but only ahead to the possibilities which God has laid out there for each of us. So today, the simple message is find a dissatisfaction and work towards fixing it. Develop a devotion. Set a direction. Let's join with others around our world who have chosen not lose some weight, but to be better people. In your head, maybe when we do that, what it will do for us is absolutely amazing, but what it will do for the world is even more amazing. Thanks be to God. Amen. Today, as we gather in this place, we come together and we do look back, even as we look forward, as I reminded you. We look back and we remember, and it sends us into the future in a new way. The tables which are set before us today, and I'd invite my servers to come forward, they're a remembering of something that Jesus did, but not just so that we would remember it, but so that we would go out into the world with the same energy, the same possibility and promise. The night in which Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread, he gave thanks, and he broke it. He gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And in the same way, that night he took the cup. And again, after giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples and he said, take, drink from this, all of you, for this is the cup of the new covenant shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Let us pray. Almighty God, send the power of your Holy Spirit on us gathered here out of love for you, that we might know in the breaking of this bread and the drinking of this wine your powerful presence in our lives and in the life of our church. Thanks be to God. Amen. As we remember, as we are called, we are also sent. And we're sent in humility around the issues that Jesus served his disciples that night around these tables. And then he sent them So today, as we gather here on the first of the year, I invite you to come. Come when you're ready. The ushers are, we're not going to send you. You come when you're ready. And then receive. Stay as long as you want and pray. When you're done, you can go back to your seats by the side aisles. Remember, everybody that's here is welcome. Nobody's required to come. I'll come out into the room for those who would like to receive in their pew. But come, everything is ready, the body and blood of Christ. Thanks be to God. If you'd like to receive in your pew, simply open your hand. The body and blood of Christ broken. The blood poured out for you, for God is with you. Thanks be to God. The body and blood of Christ broken and shed as a sign of God's love. Thanks be to God. Amen. The body and blood of Christ broken and shed. Sign of God's love. Thanks be to God. Amen. Are there others who would receive in their pew today? Body and blood of Christ broken and shed. It's a sign that God is with you. Thanks be to God. Amen. The body and blood of Christ broken and shed for you, for God is with you. Body and blood of Christ, broken and shed as a sign of God's love. Thanks be to God. Amen. Jesus said, "Come unto me, all ye that are burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you rest." The body and the blood of Christ, broken and shed for you, as a sign of God's love. Thanks be to God. The body and blood of Christ, broken and shed. The sign of God's love. Thanks be to God. The body and blood of Christ, broken and shed for you, Sally, for God is with you. Thanks be to God. Body of Christ broken. And the blood shed. Thanks be to God. Please stand. Remember, as we exit here, we're going to move into the other room. Those who would like to be a part of making the car kits with us, please join us around the tables. And next week, we'll be talking about baptism. If there are those present that would like to consider baptism, please let me know, and we'll go from there. Now, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, go in peace. Amen.